I'd say he probably gets annoyed when I usually fling out like 5 tricks before I decide on one. So he's always like, wait, what are you trying? Wait, are you going to try this? What are you going
to
try?
We don't have to go too deep into that.
Yeah, yeah.
Just roast him like,
actually. Yeah, talk your shit, bro. This spot was in Guadalajara, and it's a little bit out of the city. Aside from this, there's really like 5 other spots there along that whole plaza. I mean, I was hyped to be able to put all those 3 together for sure.
I'm in the background of that filming Ibu kickflip over the bench the other side, and Rye Bears filmed that line, and I couldn't ride down the steps, honestly, like how he did. So props to Rye. That's a fucked up line.
Harris, shout out Roman for the good facial expressions.
Shout out Lee, bro.
And Lee, right here. Yeah. Where was this?
Pennsylvania.
It's in Pennsylvania.
You almost didn't want that in there.
Oh, yeah. I was like, I don't know if that's...
It's a psycho line.
Man, we had a sick interaction with the cop at this spot. He was just hyped on skating. He pulled up, screeched to the curb, and I was like rolling up. I got shook because I was like, oh, this is my last try. I completely blew that attempt, and then he's like, I failed a frontside flip, and then he just says like, oh, come on, man, frontside flip that shit.
Didn't he ask if you're a sponsor?
Yeah, he asked if I was Flow friendly.
Not Flow.
That's in downtown, and I've actually gone there for the last couple parts. But it's just scary because if your board shoots under, it shoots onto the freeway, so you're going to smoke a car if you mess up. We actually put, like, some shoelaces to try and, like, guard it a little bit. But I don't think you can see it. Hopefully you can't. So. Ben just posted today about this because people were pretty curious how he filmed it. Like, if he was running, if he was skating, if he was on rollerblades, drone, whatever it may be. But, I mean, he rode down the double set with me. Definitely a situation, too, where he throws that idea out and I'm like, are you sure? Like, you're gonna go with me? And he's just, yeah, just trust me, we'll make it happen. So I just try to not think about him. And after a couple tries, it worked out. I mean, he used to be on Fiveboro when he was younger. I remember he'd say, like, he went on a trip to New York and stuff, and then he was getting Nikes. So he was doing it and skating a bit, you know? I remember when I first met him, we went to France to go skate with him and then going to see the spots that he's done tricks at. I'm like, this guy did it? Like, the filmer did that? And I was just tripping out. And then, after getting to know him and skate with him, you're like, yeah, he's a real deal. Filming, skating, all of it.
You mean to go straight 5-0?
It was intentional. I've always done 180 switch crooks, but that ledge was long enough that I wanted to try to get it as switchback nose grind as possible. Switch trays right now for me are a work in progress, so I was really happy on that one. And then this was, to my memory, this might be one of the first lines we filmed for this. I couldn't figure out anything to do at this parking garage because the rail was sick, and then randomly I tried to slap you up, and if you would have saw the shit I was flinging out before, I was just all over the place. I didn't know what to try, and then ended up with that. The security booth is at the front of this roll-up, so you really only have one try. I didn't really like the roll-away. I felt like it was a bit sketchy, but I mean, you get one try at it, so... We found that spot on accident.
This girl ran over all my camera gear there. She was drunk driving.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
She, like, focused my tripod. It was insane.
I I smithed this rail in Philly, and I wasn't bummed on it. When I watched the clip, I look in the background, and Brian O'Dwyer's kind of like this. And I'm like, was that good or bad? Like, I'll redo it, just let me know. Because I kind of like hit my hand in the bush.
This spot is crazy, actually. That's in Indianapolis. This kid actually came up and met Louie and started crying in the middle of this session. It was pretty awesome.
That was nuts. And honestly, like, if you're going to come up with that type of energy, like, I'm going to shed some tears, too. So I shed some tears with him. I was like, damn, like, come on, chill out. It's all good. Just got deep with me and started crying. It was just like, thanks, bro, thanks, bro. And I was like, oh, shit. My eyes got all watery, too. I'm like, fuck.
I have the funniest footage, though. Like, he's just crying his eyes out, and then I start filming him. He's like,
all right, but yeah, shout out Indianapolis. What you know about it?
And then, like, got all hard. I was like, damn, bro. Changed up on us real quick. It was pretty sick.
This 50 shove it, John Coulthard. Every time I do a trick that's not a still photo, I'll tell him that's what I'm trying, and he's like, oh. If he gets all bummed, and it happens to me, I'll like fling something out, and he'll be so hyped. He's like, yes, that's looking good. And then I'll switch it up to something that's just like a sequence style trick, and he's just like, oh. But this one, when I tried 50 shove, was one of those cases. He actually shot it weird. He shot the shove out of the 50. And it actually made a pretty sick photo, and he was actually pretty hyped on it. And it's not really a normal one you'd shoot like that. Like, a 50 shove it isn't really a still photo. Converse actually just surprised me with two billboards in Hollywood that are insane. They're like four stories tall. Who would have thought that 50 shove it was on a billboard? Like, we would have never guessed. We flip this thing around. Can you see like the background of that bar? It's actually a bump to bar, but it wasn't locked in the ground, so we flipped it and made it like a bump to rail.
Did Pizza show you that spot?
Shout out Pizza.
Pizza Ross?
Pizza Ross. A lot of the Philly stuff was three tricks a day. That was the goal I set for myself. I was like, I want to try to at least get three tricks a day. I mean, we got pretty close in Philly, so almost every day was like three tricks a day. So when I was rolling up to that board slide, I heard Eric Herrera and Brian O'Dwyer were like near the roll up laughing. I'm kind of trying to focus, so I was like, what are they laughing at? Like, this is kind of bugging me out. And then I went and I landed the board slide and I rolled away. And I was hyped, but then I turn around and they're running to me right as I landed it, and I was super hyped to land the board slide. They show me the phone, and then I guess that's how I found out I got the Thrasher cover of the 50 in Paris.
There yesterday.
You did?
It's
still cut?
No, it's super knob now. They welded a bunch of shit on the fence.
So this fence for a while was pieced together very lightly so you could take it apart. I mean, to get speed for it, we used a bungee, but we are pretty good at hiding that. Shout out Ben Ramers. That t-shirt, I put that on and I was like, I gotta try to get something solid in this. I really wanted this slam clip in here because every time I slam and it hurts so bad, the clip looks like nothing. So I was hyped on this one because I was like, all right, it looks like something like I firecrackered it with my hip and hit my head and broke the tile. Like, I gotta throw that in there. I watched a funny YouTube thing where someone was like reviewing the video, and this guy was like mad at John because he's like, how could you yawn after this happened? That's so disrespectful. But he's actually just like really excited.
A lot of the main stuff I wasn't there for, to be honest with you, because I was in the house editing while Louie's out getting it, so.
He was in the lab.
Like, Ben Shadorn and Cody Green filmed like a lot of the good stuff.
Shout out Cody Green.
Yeah, I'm really thankful for them.
The last two months, he was really out there with me. This spot, I ollied it, and then I actually went there just like, I want to ollie over the rail. And then we saw the clip, and I was just like, I have to do something better than ollie, because ollie doesn't really translate. My goal for this video was to just try and completely focus and put all my time and energy into just filming this video. Well, yeah, I haven't drank in a year. Now, I didn't have a problem or anything, but I just wanted to like completely just try and be as healthy as I could be and just see what comes from that. See if I notice any difference or anything. So we had the premiere date set and that, and then we actually had some troubles with music licensing, so it actually, the part was supposed to come out November
20th, on Black Friday,
and then we had some troubles with music and stuff, so it ended up coming out December 5th. I was bummed, but I was like, at the same time, it gives me more time to film and try to really make this how I want to make it, so a lot of this stuff right here was after the premiere. This half camp flip, you get like 5 minutes. That was probably like six times back at this point.
That was
crazy. So I actually, the first time we went there, this was the second time, we were like in a cab or something meeting Ben at this other spot. And we were like, oh, what's good with that? And then kind of didn't think about it, and we actually were just messing around, me and Eddie Cernicky. And we literally started from 5 feet up and like had Ben film us on his phone. We're like, yo, get us back to back. And we just kept working our way up. And then sure enough, we were close enough to the top, so where the bar's cut so you can go under it. We had no clue who had done it or anything like that. So definitely wasn't trying to step on anyone's toes, didn't have any clue. We just pulled up, saw it off the side of the road. And actually that time I ended up doing a half cab flip into it just from the pad. And then ducked it. And that never came out. We never put that one out. But I had known in the back of my head that this 50 was an option. I'm glad to give my love to you. I know you feel the way I do. Anything.
I think three of the songs didn't clear.
It was almost the only song we had approved, really, was like Killing Joke, right?
Yeah.
And then everything else, like, just took us through the ringer. Like, we got let on, and then right before the premiere, they were like, no, we're over it, actually. And then,
your last song went from Roy Orbison to, we did Bruce Springsteen for the premiere. Hey, little girl, is your daddy home? Did he go and leave you all alone? I got a bad desire. Just for fun,
yeah.
And then ended up on this song.
Yeah,
they cleared it in like a week.
Yeah, so it all worked out.
It's just a shit show.
It was madness.
It was harsh.
I'm actually really stoked on the way it turned out. That like I think everything happened for a reason on this. And honestly, I was trying to get another ender. I have a pet peeve of like having a cover be an ender, because I feel like it's just expected. So I was trying to get another ender that would go after this, but nothing worked out, so we ended up using it, but just want everyone to know that we tried.